Thanks for everybody's help getting my phone set up and all that.
Why were they
screaming? Where are you?
Okay. Why were they not where they usually are?
Who put them
well,
there?
Because Travis and I are on the same page. We are go back and forth by the hour, by the second, with everything's going to be fine. With all holy, oh my God, what is happening at the Pentagon? Okay,
it's going to be fine.
Yeah. Well, of course you're always wrong, so that's comforting. Okay.
I was right about Trump being president.
I'm sorry. What? All right, just don't talk for the rest of the show. All right, Paula tweets, this feels like November 9th, 1989, when the Berlin Wall fell and the Stasi began destroying documents, hiding their crimes, and destroying evidence. Trump wants us to know that Esper and DOD have on him and his administration. Expect the exact same purge in the rest of the IC. We will ask Frank Flaguzzi about that.
Yeah.
What former FBI agent Frank Flaguzzi will join us in just a bit. Because who knows, right, what he's doing? He's obviously putting a bunch of stooges in, the people that were Russia deniers. I assume, I wouldn't be surprised at anything at this point, right?
It's like one of those things where you don't even know what to make of it at this point, because it's just so ridiculous.
Yeah.
This was like Devin Nunes' low-level staffer,
right,
who somehow has like climbed the ranks because he knows something.
And the guy that called Obama a terrorist.
Yeah, that
and,
too.
Yeah. So, you're like, I don't know. What, troops that will fire on civilians. He's hoping for that. I don't know. Pull troops out of Afghanistan immediately. I don't know what. Who knows what he's doing, right? But it's causing a bit of stress.
So is Jamie right now.
What is Jamie doing? Jamie's.
She's trying to take us off the air.
Also, my button's stuck, so we're gonna hear stooges all morning. Oh no, we're not. Okay, it's back. All right, you can talk again.
Can we? Jamie may take us off the air.
My opinion doesn't count.
Yes, listen, it is genuinely, when you have the Secretary of State of the United States say we will have a smooth transition to second Trump term, it's terrifying, whether it's a stupid joke or not. It's not funny. The peaceful transfer of power. Everyone around the world is watching this.
These are narcissistic people who have lost an election, and they are doing anything they can to try and keep power. It's not going to work because, yes, they flouted norms before, but they're going to run into the buzzsaw of actual laws come January 20th.
That is an unfortunate headline for them this morning. Election officials nationwide find no fraud. Banner headline on this morning's New York Times.
Yes. Yeah.
So the New York Times contacted election officials across the entire country in every state.
Yes.
Yes,
all
in every
states.
State. Top election officials said that the election had been a remarkable success despite record turnout and the complications of a dangerous pandemic. There is a great human capacity for inventing things that aren't true about elections, said the Republican who serves as Ohio's Secretary of State, for instance. Okay, so he has tweeted 22 times all night, retweets, retweets, mm-hmm. So we're sort of half, we haven't seen him, so it's half Howard Hughes, half Hitler in the bunker.
He's saving his urine in jars by the front door.
Norma Desmond.
Yeah,
little Norma Desmond thrown in. Okay.
They're interviewing interns for jobs next year.
Right, they're okaying a budget, Trump's budget for February. Secretary of State says that we're getting ready for a transition to a second Trump term. So everything's normal, everything's fine, everything's good.
It's just posturing.
Okay,
it's
they won't.
Just posturing.
All right, are you going to use that tone that's either patronizing or condescending all morning?
I'm telling you, it's just
I believe that we have a hidden microphone at the Pentagon right
we
now.
We have to strike now, sir. Yeah. Annihilate. Right. Kill. Kill. Kill.
Shut up.
Okay.
Shut up. Shut up.
You know they're probably destroying what's on that server.
That's
right?
The bigger concern right now.
Right? The call to the Ukraine, that whatever, with Putin, God knows, right?
Yeah. Oh.
And at this point, nothing would surprise you, right? Like, not only destroying evidence, I don't know, are they planning evidence that is going to suddenly exonerate Trump in the Trump Russia? Seriously, Devin Nunes, that clown's person, whatever.
I've had my eye on those characters for a while because that's what my bones represented.
Right?
Representatives up there.
Nunes.
Also, I have a distant relative who's in the military, like fairly high up. He hated Pompeo. Hated him with
He's such
white,
a smug
rage.
Bastard.
He says he was the most arrogant bastard.
I don't care what that was. That was disgraceful.
Yeah.
That the Secretary of State. And then how about all these coward Republicans? They're asking, did you congratulate Joe Biden? Nothing to congratulate him for, says noted Russian disinformation agent Ron Johnson, right?
Yeah.
Nothing to. Oh, I don't know. I. Oh my God.
Is
Joe Biden the president elect? Oh, I don't know. It's like run away from the cameras. What a bunch of. Ah, what a disgusting group of people. They're just. I. Oh my God. And I guess they're saying, oh, this is all about them ginning up their base for the for Georgia. Well, you're ginning up our base. Let me tell you what. Right. I mean,
dysfunctionality.
But they're turning on themselves, on each other, right? Matt Gaetz is saying Brian Kemp, stupid Brian Kemp, didn't set us up to win. Oh, you mean like figure out how to keep more black people from not voting? Like what? Is that what he said on Hannity?
I don't know if those are the exact words, but it was implied.
Right. Matt Gaetz said he took a shots at Brian Kemp, the Republican douchebag governor of. Okay. So and also they've been trying to get the Republican Secretary of State to resign because he also apparently accidentally let too many black people vote. Okay. Why do they keep doing stories about Democrats in disarray? What is that? They are a big bag of rats right now, Republicans. They are. Okay. Okay. Oh, how about this? Apparently there's a million MAGA march on Washington scheduled for November 14th because Trump is butthurt about. So then that will be another super spreader that will kill the rest of them that haven't already been killed by his super spreader rallies. Okay. I love, it's one of my particular favorites, is a lot of MAGAs have booked rooms for Trump's re-inauguration at the Trump Hotel.
They're going to burn that place down.
Which I assume they are not going to get their money back. Get their deposits
you
back.
You don't get those deposits back.
Because they are coming for Trump's inauguration. So they've already booked, I believe the Trump International is all booked up already. So that's.
Oh my God.
Do you think good job, MAGAs. So whatever money you didn't already give him or sent to his reelection effort, which is just going to pay off his debt. Good job. Book a room. Also a non-refundable flight. That is going to, Joe Biden's inauguration is going to be very, very stressful for them, I would imagine. What with all the money they've put out.
Do you think they'll stage like a fake inauguration for Trump at the Trump Hotel and just tell them and all of his fans will be there and he'll like think?
Would you be surprised?
And then they'll bury a chimpanzee. There'll be a monkey funeral.
Right, right. I can't decide if this is more terrifying, pathetic, hilarious. It just goes back and forth depending on what the story
it's
is.
Pathetic.
I mean, even staffers that are having to do Trump's budget for February are like, what the, right? What are we doing?
Catch you looking for a new job, we'll fire you.
Right, right. So they're panicking looking for jobs. And they're like, we're going to fire you if you. Okay.
That's what they get for laying down in bed with Trump.
Oh, how about this one? Republicans are bribing postal workers to commit federal crimes to steal an election. This is the stuff of Banana Republics. Really American tweets. There's that. The one guy that was the election fraud guy is a child molester.
Uh-huh.
That was next to Giuliani at the landscape. Okay. And then this guy recanted. Is this in Philadelphia?
Yeah.
He recanted. So he... Right.
But was this one of the investigations that Bill Barr launched?
I don't.
Because that'd be amazing.
Okay.
They're going to investigate credible claims of voter fraud, and then he recants.
I don't. That guy, okay, hang on. There's a lot this morning. Oh, the postal worker.
Yes.
Pardon me. Yes. A Pennsylvania postal worker whose claims have been cited by Republicans as potential evidence of widespread voting irregularities admitted to U.S. Postal Service inspectors that he fabricated the allegations. Oh, dear. Oh, dear. This does not. That and the New York Times headline. This is not going well for them. Richard Hopkins, we'll call you Dick, claimed that a postmaster in Erie, Pennsylvania instructed postal workers to backdate ballots mailed after Election Day was cited by Lindsey Graham in his letter to the Department of Justice. But Monday, he told investigators that the allegations were not true. Okay. All right.
And there's also the list of names in Nevada. Did you hear about this story?
Which one is this?
This is the Republicans thought they found a list of names of people who say they resided in Nevada, but actually resided in other states.
Uh-huh.
It turns out that these people were residents of Nevada, but were military families, and so were stationed all over the country.
Oh.
Yes.
Oh, see, that's when he turned. Oh, happy Veterans Day, by the way, and
exactly.
happy coup at the Pentagon.
Yeah.
Everybody.
Yeah. So.
Yeah. Right, because he's turned on military. Oh, that was one of their evidences that some poll guy said, well, I just thought it was suspicious so many military voters are voting for Biden. Unless, of course, troops don't like being called suckers and losers and you attacking dead war heroes. from Arizona. I don't know. Maybe there's...
And telling them that they voted illegally because they weren't in the state. That...
And also putting a bounty on their heads. Yeah. I mean, maybe they're touchy. Yeah. Who knows?
I mean, Biden does have a spot, soft spot for the military, you know, having a son that served and all.
So that would be the evidence, is he just thought it was hinky.
Yes.
Even though the Military Times poll showed that Biden was winning the military vote by quite a bit.
Right.
Because, okay, I won't. All right, yes, Charles says, we're either witnessing the messy, disruptive, turbulent end of an illegitimate, lawless presidency riddled with corruption, incompetence, ignorance, and scandal, or a slow-motion coup to overthrow the election result engineered by a maniacally deranged, fascist-minded demagogue refusing to go. Either way, good morning. Good morning. Good morning.
Good morning.
It's great to wake up late, isn't it?
But you know what? Have you been sleeping better?
Good morning.
Not really. I was.
We've talked the whole night.
And now I'm a little.
Good morning.
I'm still sleeping good.
Yeah.
Good morning.
Okay.
Good morning.
Oh, here's a sunny side tweet. Brian Schatz says, it just occurred to me that Trump's refusal to concede means that every day the story is that he lost.
True. That's glass half full.
What's the top story again? You lost. You lost, you losy loser. Losy loser from McLoser Town.
You're gonna keep talking about it. You admit it.
I already have a stack of, is it wrong how happy it makes me, the stack about how grumpy he is?
It's really hard to decide which ones to send you.
Oh, Vanity Fair. He'll be like a used car coming off the lot.
Vanity Fair has the best.
Trump, can I have the tiniest of violin? As Trump. He'll be like a used car coming off the lot. As Trump clings to power, his allies quietly admit defeat. I spoke with half dozen Republicans close to the White House. They uniformly agreed that Trump is done. It's over, said one campaign advisor. Even members of Trump's legal team have privately said there's virtually no chance. Are these the lawyers with the sticky notes? That's their evidence, is that somebody said a thing about a guy that someone told them and I wrote it on a sticky?
You know, he doesn't have a law degree. Give him a break.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Mueller, she wrote, our friend AG reminds us.
Sorry.
In case you were feeling anxious. Trump's legal advisor for the election lawsuits doesn't have a law degree or even a bachelor's degree, but he does have COVID. So that's...
What's that?
Okay. I'm sorry. Back to the story, Sean. Sources say West Wing aides and members of Trump's family are scared to confront him directly. They're telling him it's unlikely, but not impossible, to change the result. The Lord of the Flies atmosphere has enveloped the West Wing. Trump advisors accusing each other of looking out for themselves. Republicans have suggested that... Another Republican suggested that Giuliani and Bannon are pushing the most extreme election fraud conspiracies because they want to curry favor with Trump for pardons. Yeah, it's weird. The people most likely to go to prison seem to be the most invested in this whole election fraud thing. Trump is kind of keep the MAGA movement going, but Trump is going to find out is that the minute he leaves the White House, he'll be like a used car coming off the lot. His value will drop. His staff is losing patience. Why put up with it anymore? They're tired of his... Okay.
And the staff is going to, I mean, if they quit, have the stink of Trump on their resume. So how are they going to get jobs?
They're looking for jobs. Oh, wait, there's more stories, Sean. Trump is watching television and complaining about a lack of public support for Allegate. Oh, that's right. 80% of the American people think that Joe Biden won.
Yes.
Okay. And the only reason it's not is because, some Republicans apparently feel like they have to buy into this. Okay. The president is described as angry and frustrated, often doing things he's done throughout his presidency, watching TV and complaining people aren't out there defending him, his baseless claims. Mark Meadows is playing a big role in feeding the president's claim the election's being stolen. Does he take the ventilator off to do that and then put it back on? Is it a portable ventilator? Okay.
It's scuba gear. He can carry it on his back.
Does he? Is he wearing flippers?
Uh-huh.
Okay, this one, real quick, my favorite. It's like George Costanza deciding just to go back to the office on Monday as if he didn't quit on the Friday before. Trump apparently thinks he can just go on being president, even the American people have fired him. Trump is reportedly not compared to concession speech, and he has told allies he has no intention of conceding.
The
decision to go full delusional has obviously been strengthened by some staffers like Mark Meadows.
I don't expect him to give a concession speech
he won't
at
ever.
All.
He won't ever.
At all.
He won't ever. Okay. Oh, and he's obviously not going to the inauguration because who wants the turd in the punch bowl? Nobody.
He'll be his own huge inauguration over at the Trump Hotel.
Huh?
He'll be his own huge inauguration at the Trump Hotel.
All right. Or I'm just saying, listen, we have time. I've worn my impeach shirt because there's a shelf life for them. And B, we have time. If you want to stop him from some of this stuff, right? Get the funding to the Biden transition. Stop whatever he's doing at the Pentagon. Let's keep him busy. Him and Barr. We got time. It's impeach. I'm good with what Glenn Kushner said yesterday. Indict now. Yeah. Let's take a maiden legal voyage. Let's go, New York. Let's indict now. Let's impeach now. Let's keep him from destroying, right?
Mm-hmm.
Document. You know that's what they're doing. They're destroying the DOD server. They're destroying documents. That's what he wants to do. He wants to find out what they have on him, right?
Wait, is there going to be acid and bleach involved like he accused Hillary of with the
acid
cell phones?
With a hammer and acid.
They're acid washing.
All right, I'm going back to laughing, and then I'll be back to being terrified in a minute. Okay, and then we have a show. We have Carlos Hells Rocky, Malcolm Nance, Bob Seska, and Frank Luguzzi. That's a lot of man meat. A lot of sexy liberal man meat.
Those are a lot of tough men.
Yes.
Good Lord.
Right. I like a ship with men. I
wonder how many people among them they've killed.
I needed to be shored up this morning.
Men, 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 men.
All men in here, except for Jeff. Men, 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 men.